In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious and the Most Merciful. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. I hope that you all are fine and safe at home. This is General Science Lecture for Grade 6. Today is Wednesday, 6th of May 2020. The chapter we are studying is Element, the simplest kind of matter. And this is your teacher, Ms. Kausar. Okay, students, in previous lecture, I explained classifying elements, the periodic table. So we will continue the topic classifying elements, and in today's lecture we will learn about metals and non-metals. We talk about the classification of elements in the periodic table. Then elements in the periodic table are broadly classified or divided into two main groups, and that groups are metals and non-metals. So in today's lecture I've explained the properties of metals and the properties of non-metals. So let's see what are the main properties of metals. Okay, so let's see what are the properties of metals. The first one property of metal is metals have shiny surface. Less shiny or more shiny, but it is one of the properties of metals that metals will always have a shiny surface. These are some of the examples of metals. You can see they all have shiny surfaces. Okay, so one of the properties of metal is that they have shiny surface. Okay, the next property is metals have high density. Now, what is meant by density? Density means mass per unit volume. In simple words, we can say that density is compactness of a substance. Now, what is meant by compactness? Let's suppose we have these two substances. Okay, you can see here the particles present inside of this substance. These particles are very closely packed together and they are having no space in between, while the particles present here are having spaces in between and they are far away from each other. So when the particles are very closely packed together with no spaces or very little spaces, we can say that they are compactly packed together. Any substance in which the particles are compactly packed together are known as substances with higher density, or you can say they are the denser substances. Okay, their density will be very high, but if there is space between the particles, then that substance will have low density. Okay, here the particles are not closely packed together. The compactness is very low, they are not compactly packed together, so we can say that the density is low. But here the particles are compactly packed together or very tightly packed together, so the substance will have high density. Inside metals, the particles or the atoms of metals are very tightly packed together. In this way they are packed together with no space or very little space, so metals are having very high density. As compared to non-metals, metals are having very high density. Okay, it is one of the properties of metals. Okay, the next property is metals have high melting point. Now, what is meant by melting point? Melting point is the temperature at which a solid changes into liquid. For example, we have ice which is present in solid form. When we provide heat to it, when we heat up it, what will happen? This ice will melt, and when this ice melts, it will convert into liquid water. So the temperature at which the ice melts is known as melting point. Metals are present in solid form, so they can also be melted, but the temperature at which the metals are melted is extremely high temperature. So we can say that metals are having very high melting point, very high temperature. Okay, the temperature at which the metal can be melted, that is the melting point. So metals are having very high melting point. The next property of metals is metals are very good electrical and heat conductors. You might have seen most of the utensils, cooking utensils we are using at home, they are made up of metals. Why cooking utensils are mainly made up of metals? Because they are very good heat conductors. And if you see the electrical wires also contain metallic wires inside. Why the metallic wires are used? Because metals are very good electrical conductors. These are some of the examples of good conductors, and you can see all the conductors are in metallic form. So it is one of the properties of metals that metals will be good conductor of heat and electricity. And I had already explained in previous lecture what is meant by conductor. Conductor means a substance which can allow electricity or heat to pass through them, okay? So metals allow heat and electricity to pass through them. That's why metals are very good electrical and heat conductor. Okay, metals are ductile. Now, what is meant by ductile? Ductile means they can be drawn into wires. We can make wires out of metals, okay? Metals can be drawn into wires. The electrical wires, the metallic wires present in electrical wires are, you might have seen the electrical wires, okay? That is because this is one of the speciality of metals that they can be drawn into wires, and this property of metal is known as ductility. So we can say that metals are ductile, means we can make wires from metals. Okay, the next property is metals are malleable. They are malleable. Now, what is meant by malleable? Malleable means they can be beaten into shapes or sheet. Okay, you might have seen cooking utensils at your home. The cooking utensils which are made of metals, they are present in different shapes. So why they are present in different shapes? Because metal can be beaten into different shape because of its property known as malleability. Metals are malleable, so metals can be beaten into different shapes. This is the example of metallic sheet. The common example of metallic sheet is aluminum foil, which you might have seen at your home, where it is mostly used to cover food stuff. So why metals are present in form of sheet or different shapes? Because of its property called malleability. Okay, so metals are malleable means it can be beaten into shapes or sheet. Okay, the next property is metals are sonorous. Okay, they are sonorous. Now, what is meant by sonorous? Sonorous means they give a ringing sound when hit. Let's take an example. Okay, here we have two plates, a steel plate and a plastic plate. If we hit both the plates with a spoon or anything else, this one plate will produce a ringing sound, while this plastic plate will not produce a ringing sound. So why this plate produces a ringing sound and the plastic one is not producing such sound? The reason is this plate is made of steel, which is a metal, and metals are having special property that they are sonorous, means they produce a ringing sound when hit. On the other hand, plastic plate, as you know, plastic is not a metal, so when we hit a plastic plate, it will not produce a ringing sound. Although it will produce a sound, but that sound will not be ringing one. So it do not produce ringing sound because plastic is a non-metal, and producing a ringing sound is the property of metals, and this property is known as sonorous. Okay, so metals are sonorous. Okay, if we talk about the physical state of metal, then all metals are solid at room temperature except one, which is in liquid state. So can you name the metal which is present in liquid state? It is the most common metal, and you might have seen that at your home as well. Yes, that metal is mercury. Okay, so mercury is the only metal which is present in liquid state, while all other metals are present in solid state. Okay, this is the mercury, and this mercury is mostly used in clinical thermometer, which is used to measure human temperature. Okay, human body's temperature, and it is, I think it's present at your home, in everyone's home, the thermometer. You can see the liquid present inside the thermometer is mercury, which is metal. Okay, so these were some of the properties of metals. Now let's see what are the properties of non-metals. Okay, the first property of non-metals is non-metals have dull appearance. Okay, means they do not have shiny appearance like metals. You can see these are the examples of non-metals, plastic spoons and wood. You can see their surfaces are very dull. They are not having shiny surfaces. So this is one of the properties of non-metals, that they have dull surfaces. Okay, non-metals have low densities as compared to metals. The density of non-metals will be low. Okay, means the particles present inside non-metals will have spaces in between them. They will not be compactly packed together. Also, non-metals have very low melting point. If we compare the non-metals with metals, then non-metals, the solid non-metals can be melted at low temperature as compared to metals. Okay, metals are non-ductile. Non-ductile means they cannot be drawn into wires. They are non-sonorous. As I explained earlier, non-metals do not produce a ringing sound when hit. So they are non-sonorous, and non-metals are brittle. Brittle means that can be broken down easily, means we can break them easily as compared to metals. Okay, non-metals are present in all three states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. We have 22 non-metals. Okay, out of these 22 non-metals, 10 non-metals are present in solid form, 11 non-metals are present in gaseous form, while one non-metal is there which is present in liquid state. Now let's see what are the elements which are present in solid form, the non-metals which are present in solid state. So these are the name of the elements which are present in solid state at room temperature, that is boron, carbon, silicon, phosphorus, arsenic, selenium, tellurium, iodine, astatine and sulfur. So these are the 10 non-metals which are present in solid state at room temperature, while there is only one non-metal which is present in liquid form, while other non-metals all are present in gaseous form. Okay, so it will be your homework to name the non-metal which is present in liquid form. Okay, if we talk about the conductance, then all non-metals are bad conductor of heat and electricity, but there is one non-metal which is a very good electrical conductor, and it was your homework. I gave you this as homework in previous lecture, that name the only non-metal which is a very good electrical conductor. I hope you have found out the name of that non-metal. So what is the name of that non-metal which is a good conductor of electricity? Okay, so the non-metal which is a very good electrical conductor is graphite. Carbon, okay? Carbon is a non-metal, and carbon is present in many forms, but when carbon is present in graphite form, we call that a very good conductor. This graphite carbon is mainly used in making pencils. This pencil nib is actually graphite carbon, okay? And this is the raw form of graphite carbon. So graphite carbon is the only non-metal which is a very good conductor of electricity. These are all about the properties of metals and non-metals. I hope it's clear to all of you. So now let's move towards our today's homework. Okay, students, your homework is you'll have to write down the names of 10 metals and non-metals which are present in your surroundings. And as I mentioned earlier, your second homework is you'll have to name the only non-metal which is present in liquid form. Okay, so watch and listen the video very carefully and try to make yourself understand. Do your homework, take good care of yourself, and enjoy your Ramadan. Allah Hafiz.